in the womb. Or dedication.
Hey, Mom.
Let us pray. Gracious and almighty God, we give you thanks for the compassion you've shown to us, but even more so for the dedication that your Son has shown to our salvation. Help us to be dedicated to you, to your cause, to your church, so that our lives are a reflection of your light. In your name we pray. Amen. All right. New Year's Day, correct? First of all, good job making it. I'm proud of you. Now, New Year's resolutions. Who made them? Well, there goes that sermon. We don't make them, do we? Remember a time when we did? Folks used to make them all the time. Number one was, this year I'm going to lose weight. And then we stay up past midnight eating and drinking and partying and wake up early the next day. And what do we feel like not doing? Losing weight, exercising, any of that. What's number two? What else did we do? We did. What were resolutions that you've done? Yes, sir?
Trying to run every single day.
Trying to run every single day. You know what? This year, I am going to run 5 miles every single day, and I'm going to do it uphill both ways, and I'm... That last night. First ice storm, first head cold. No. But we want to. We make plans, generally on Mondays, or the first of the month, or the first of the year. Whenever there's a new beginning, we make these plans to dedicate ourselves to something better. Because we're not quite happy with where we're at. Our New Year's resolutions normally show us a glimpse of something that we want to fix, or tweak, or make a little better. And it's sort of like that car that you have, you just want to do a little bit, like put the Lambo doors on. Just something a little bit different. And so we dedicate ourselves.
We're going to do this now.
Sometimes it works. Sometimes it doesn't. But you know what? Trying and failing is not a bad thing. Failing to try is. Case in point, our gospel. God sent into the world his Son. Right? The whole Christmas thing, little baby, manger, animals, shepherds, wise men, little drummer playing something. Right? Go like this. Be awake! Okay, good. God is trying. From the moment of creation, God is trying to make a good world and a good life for us. The Garden of Eden, the deliverance. Eden. That's a slip. The Garden of Eden, the deliverance from slavery, the deliverance into the promised land, milk and honey, manna, on and on and on, until finally, Christ. God is so dedicated to us that he sends his Son here to the barn to start out to show us that we will be saved. That he will not fail to try, but he will try and not fail to save us. Because when we try, sometimes we do it, sometimes we don't. But Christ also comes to show us how to be dedicated. How to do the things that we're called to do. What to focus on. How to improve ourselves. And when we get to these firsts, like today, first of the year, first time without coffee before a sermon, it's time to rededicate. You didn't make great New Year's resolutions. That's all right. But what I'd invite you to do today is make a faith resolution, a rededication of faith. What is important in your life between you and Christ? Christ this year, this day, right now, that you want to do, that you want to pursue, that will draw you forward into something better? What is it you want to tweak? What is it you want to soup up? What is it you want to fix? What is it that God has been nagging you about? And then focus on doing it. You don't have to succeed. That's the glory of it. God already promises us that no matter what happens here, even if we die, which we will, we'll live on forever through Him. But as a thank you for that, we get to live and try and take chances and risks and reach out for something greater than we could ever do on our own. This year, you're going to have a lot of chances for dedications to tweak those things in your faith life. We've got fellowship events where you can tweak bringing family or being active with other folks who share your faith. We've got slips of paper in the back for the financial stuff, for rededicating how we give and when we give and what we give. We've got letters going out to the heads of all the committees right now from those times and talent sheets. So there are times and talents that we spilled out will be used, or at least noticed and commented on, and so much more. Prayer chains and flower deliveries and worship here. Choir. Going forth into the community. This year, don't be afraid to try. Let us rededicate ourselves. Ourselves, our time, our possessions, our souls to the ministry here. It's good for us. We won't feel hungover afterwards. And we've got a great leader to follow. Him. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen.